watching episode 12 of our .NET Core interview series. In this episode, we dive into a real-world essential, JWT authentication and role-based authorization in ASP.NET Core. Let's hear how Arohi sets it up securely and cleanly in production apps. Arohi, let's begin at the top. What is JWT and why do we use it?
JWT stands for JSON Web Token. It's a compact, self-contained way to transmit user identity between the client and server securely. In ASP.NET Core, we use JWTs for stateless authentication in APIs. No need to store sessions on the server.
Can you break down the structure of a JWT?
Sure. A JWT has three parts. Header includes algorithm and token type. Payload contains user claims like user ID, role, email. Signature ensures the token is secure and hasn't been tampered with.
Walk us through the setup.
Absolutely. The first step is in Program.cs, where I register the authentication services. I call builder.services.addAuthentication and specify the JWT bearer scheme as the default. Then, I configure the JWT bearer itself by calling .addJWTBearer. This is where I set up the token validation parameters. Things like making sure the issuer, audience, and lifetime of the token are all validated. And most importantly, validating the signing key. All these values, of course, are pulled securely from my app's configuration, not hard-coded. Finally, in the middleware pipeline, it's crucial to call app.useAuthentication, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, before app.useAuthorization, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, to ensure the user's identity is established before we check their permissions.
How is the token actually created?
Token generation typically happens in a login or authentication method after a user's credentials have been verified. I start by using the JWT security token handler to do the heavy lifting. I'll define the token's content using a security token descriptor. This is just an object that describes what goes into the token. The most important part is the subject, where I create a new claims identity and add the user's claims, like their username and, critically, their role from the database. I'll also set an expiration time, usually something short, like 1 hour, for security. Finally, I define the signing credentials. This involves taking my secret key, creating a symmetric security key with it, and specifying the signing algorithm, which is typically HMAC-SHA-256. Once the descriptor is ready, I just call tokenhandler.createToken and then tokenhandler.writeToken to get the final, serialized JWT string that I can send back to the client.
How do you restrict access?
This is the really elegant part of ASP.NET Core. Once authentication is set up, I can protect my endpoints simply by using the Authorize attribute. I can apply it to an entire controller to protect all its actions, or to a specific action method for more granular control. To take it a step further for authorization, I can specify roles directly in the attribute. For example, if I have an endpoint that only administrators should access, I'll decorate it with authorize, roles equals admin. This tells the ASP.NET Core pipeline that before executing this action, it must ensure the user has a valid JWT and that the token contains a role claim with the value admin.
This is a common confusion. Can you clarify?
Authentication is verifying who the user is, for example, checking JWT. Authorization is checking what the user is allowed to do, for example, role-based access. Both are configured in middleware and attributes.
Where does the token live on the client?
The token is usually stored in local storage or session storage and sent with every API request via the authorization header, authorization bearer token.
What if the token expires?
JWT tokens are short-lived for security. I implement a refresh token strategy where a second long-lived token allows the user to request a new access token when it expires. This is often done via a dedicated refresh endpoint.
Can users have multiple roles?
Yes, I include multiple claim types role in the token. Then I use authorize ass authorization equals admin manager to allow access to multiple roles. For fine-grained access, I also use policy-based authorization.
Where do you keep the signing key?
Never hard-coded. I store secrets in Azure Key Vault or user secrets during development. In production, keys are pulled securely from configuration or secret managers.
Great job, Arohi. Securing APIs is a must, and you've clearly implemented JWT the right way. If you learned something new, give this video a like, comment below with your thoughts, and subscribe to the .NET Way for more in this series. In episode 13, we'll discuss logging and monitoring. How do you track live apps in production? Thanks for watching. See you next time.